It's Microsoft Build Time. The annual developer event is 100% online this year again, and I watched every single session to figure out the top three takeaways just for you. Now, if you're interested in cloud computing and want to learn more about it in a fun and engaging way, consider subscribing to this channel. Oh, and while I've got you here, I would love for you to help us out with a short survey. We genuinely want to create content that you like, and you'll find a link for it just below in the resources. While there isn't any, wow, this is new and amazing and will change the world forever kind of news, there were many improvements and upgrades to lots of things. I guess that is a sign of products maturing and being more stable, and I'll take that. Okay, let's start with number three. And the third strongest trend from Microsoft Build is data. Of course, data is the food for any computing system, so it makes sense Microsoft is upping its Azure data game. The most interesting new data feature is the ledger capability for Azure SQL database. This adds tamper evidence capabilities to your Azure SQL databases using blockchain technology, but without blockchain infrastructure. Microsoft has abstracted away all the complexity of setting up blockchain for your data and pretty much made it a button in Azure. You simply enable ledger functionality on the tables you want and keep using SQL like normal. But now you can tell if the data has been tampered with. Nifty. Other notable mentions in the Azure data space are updates for Cosmos DB to expand the free tier and provide partial document updates. 12 months free use of Azure databases for PostgreSQL and MySQL, Azure Synapse updates for hardware acceleration and Dataverse integration. One of Azure's strong points is number two, hybrid. With the historic customer base of Windows Server, Active Directory, and many other Microsoft products, there are a lot of companies that have existing infrastructure, which they seek to enhance with cloud powder. Sprinkle it on. At Microsoft Build, a lot of focus was on Azure Arc. The Arc service lets you run any Windows, Linux, SQL Server, or Kubernetes cluster across data centers, whether it is on-premises, in Azure, or even in another cloud. Arc is for multi-cloud, however you define that. And at Build, some more goodies were announced for Arc. Azure App Services are now Arc-enabled, as Microsoft likes to call it, through Kubernetes. So you can have your Azure native app services like Functions and App Services and Logic Apps and Event Grid running almost anywhere. Open Service Mesh, or OSM, is now in preview with Arc. The OSM add-on simplifies integration between OSM and Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes clusters. Azure Kubernetes Services, AKS, on Azure Stack HCI is in general availability and is fully Arc enabled. They really like that term. Hang on. Grr, if only they'd named it Azure Arc, the pirate service that sneaks into other cloud platforms and plunder their resources. Okay. Was there just a pirate here? Finally, the number one trend from Build, cloud native. Now, if you aren't familiar with the term, it means using services that are 100% living on cloud platforms such as containers, service meshes, microservices, and immutable infrastructure. And there are a bunch of updates. Ready? Okay. As mentioned a moment ago, App Services, Functions, Logic Apps, API Management, and Event Grid can now run on Kubernetes clusters anywhere across on-premises, multi-cloud, and edge environments with Azure Arc. Native support for WebSocket APIs in Azure API Management is now in preview. Azure Communication Services has a new UI library, call recording, direct routing, and much more. Azure Logic Apps has new hosting options, improved performance and developer workflows, and 4,000 extra actions for the consumption tier. Two new Azure Marketplace offers for Java Enterprise Edition EE and Jakarta EE workloads are now generally available, PowerShell support in durable functions, and a whole lot more. That is all I could fit in for MS Build 2021. What was your favorite announcement or session this year? Let me know in the comments and give us a thumbs up. Also, join our new Azure This Week Discord channel to discuss the trends from this episode, and also to interact with other students and ACG people. I'm on there! You'll find a link below in the description. As we say on the A-Cloud Guru team, when the amount of news is threatening to fill every space of our online office, seek and use your cloud. So see you next week. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.